Now, students, what's the next question? Write a short note on root mean square velocity. Sorry, not velocity. Yeah, root mean square value. Okay, for AC supply, for AC circuit. So, students, consider AC supply. So, what is generally what is AC current equation? I equals to what? I zero sine omega t. I equals to what? I zero sine omega t. So let us take omega. What is omega t represent? Omega t represent angle. No. So let me represent angle by what? Theta. So here I replace omega t by what? Theta. Okay. Students, now you have to remember the relation between. You have to remember the relation between the RMS value and the peak value. Okay. Of alternating current is given by. So students, remember this root mean square. So I RMS square is given by integration of I square. Integration of what? I square. With respect to what? Theta. Over one cycle. What is the angle for one cycle? 2 pi. Remember. What is the angle for one cycle is always 360 degree. So students, square of the RMS value is given by integration of the value of, we can say, square of I with respect to theta over a cycle. That is what is the angle here? 2 pi. So over a cycle means what is the limit here? 0 to 2 pi. Remember here. Now your definite integration will come. So students, let me find out the integration first. All of you concerned, right? What is I? Here, what is I here? I 0 I, sine theta. So what is I square? I square will be what? I 0 square sine square theta. So here I will write I 0 square into what? Sine square theta d theta. Okay, just forget these limits. Initially, I am not going to write the limits. Let me just forget that limits. So students, I 0 square is constant because this is a maximum value. So now I will take integration of sine square. How to take integration of sine square? Anyone will tell me? If you don't know, to remember the formula. We can't integrate sine square theta. Shiva sir will teach you. Don't worry. Let wait up. Hello. हाँ लेक्चर ले रहा हूँ साढ़े दस टेन थर्टी टेन थर्टी टेन थर्टी साढ़े दस बजे कॉल करूँ मैं करता हूँ लेक्चर खत्म होने के बाद कॉल करता हूँ ओके अच्छा स्टूडेंट्स कैन यू हियर मी Students, can you hear me? मेरी आवाज आ रही है. Students, can you hear me? Okay, yes, sir. Okay, so students, remember here. In order to integrate sine square theta, you have to convert. You have to apply this formula: 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2. We can't take integration of sine square theta directly. Okay. So here I will do the integration. I square RMS is equals to I 0 square upon 2 pi. Okay, and integration of what? Sine square theta is what? 1 minus cos 2 theta upon what? 2. Okay, chalo, all of you concept. Beta. So I 0 square 2 to the 4 pi. Okay, and integration of 1. With respect to theta and integration of cos 2 theta. Okay. Sine 2 theta. Okay, very good. Integration sine 2 theta. Agreed, but one more term will come, Asmita. Integration of 1 with respect to theta is what? Theta. Integration of cos 2 theta is what? Sine 2 theta. And beta, Asmita, you have to divide by 2 also. Why? Coefficient of theta. Okay, yeah, this is the rule of integration. Integration of cos theta is sine theta, agreed. But when theta is replaced by 2 theta, pi theta, 10 theta, k theta, so you have to divide by coefficient of theta. You have to remember. But students, I told you, here we just neglect to write 0 to 2 pi. 0 to 2 pi is the limits over angle 0 to 2 pi. So just you have to write 0 to 2 pi everywhere. Here also 0 to 2 pi. And finally, when you take integration After integration, you have to put a value. You know that definite integration, okay? Now I will replace theta by upper limit. If I replace theta by upper limit, what is upper limit, students? Who will tell me upper limit? Here 2 pi will come. What is upper limit here? 2 pi. So you replace theta by 2 pi. Here sine 2 to the 4 pi upon 2. Okay, this is what upper limit minus. If I put 0, so 0 sine 0, 0. So no need to write, because after substituting upper limit, the answer is what? 0. So students, let me simplify. I 0 square upon 4 pi. 2 pi. What is sine 4 pi? Sine 4 pi is 0. 0 upon anything 0. So what are remaining term? 2 pi. So what is the final answer? I 0 square upon 4 pi multiplied by 2 pi. Pi pi get cancelled. 2 ones are 2, 2s are 4. So students, I square RMS is given by I 0 square upon 2. Therefore, taking square root, if I take square root, so I 0 square become I 0 and 2 become what? Root 2. So this is what your final answer. I RMS. Now onwards, you remember I RMS is always given by I 0 by root 2. So if I RMS is given by I 0 by root 2, therefore who will tell me ERMS? ERMS is given by also E 0 upon root 2. So this is what root means square for voltage, and this is what root means square for current. Hope so you understood this particular little bit here. This is in your syllabus, huh? I think so. This is second page of this your chapter. Just understand, because in that chapter, no, it is not given. This integration simplification they don't provide. They directly provide this answer. So you should know how to take the integration. Hope so you understood. Please copy.